Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. This is Shikha Samarkar and today our topic is Computer Systems and Organization, Unit 1, Part 3. And under this there is a subtopic Boolean Logic Part 1. This video is helpful for class 11 CBSE students, those who have opted Computer Science and Informatics Practices as an optional subject, and some other students can also watch the video, those who are interested in this computer field. So let's start our topic, Boolean logic. So first the question arises here, why this Boolean logic, it is included in the syllabus, in your syllabus. So there are some points. As we know that computer, it understand only the binary language. Binary means we can say machine language. Machine language means 0 or 1. So here some points are given. Boolean logic is especially important for computer science because it fits nicely with the binary numbering system, which in which each bit has a value of either 1 or 0. Another way of looking at it is that each bit has a value of either true or false. So that's why this topic is included, because it is related to our computer science field, and we know that computer works on electricity. Electricity means simple concept is switch on and switch off. On off means true or false. True or false means 1 or 0. So let's start this topic, Boolean logic. Here some points are given. As we know the general meaning of logic, and here the term is Boolean logic. Boolean, points. Here we can see, every day we have to make logic decisions. Every day we make some logic decisions, like should I carry the book or not? Should I use calculator or not? Should I miss TV program or not? Should I do this or not? Should I do that or not? Like this kind of questions. Every day we make logic decisions like this. So each of these questions requires a yes or no. Yes or no answer. As there are only these two possible answers. Therefore, each of the above mentioned is a binary decision. These all are binary decisions. Okay. So binary decision making also applies to formal logic, like 13 minus 2 equals to 11, this is true. 13 minus 2 equals to 10, this is false. Some other kind of questions are also here, like what do you say, what do you want to do, like this. So it cannot be answered in true or false, so this is a different thing. Then logical statements or truth functions. Logical statements are sentences which can be determined to be true or false. And truth values, the results true or false that are truth values. Now, here some more points related to this Boolean logic. Actually, it is also called algebra of logic. Algebra of logic or Boolean algebra. And algebra, it's a branch of mathematics. We know this. And Mr. George Boole developed this Boolean logic. That's why the name is Boolean. So, Mr. George Boole's revolutionary paper, An Investigation of the Laws of the Thought, was published in 1854, which led to the development of new system, this Boolean logic. Logic problems are binary decisions, and Boolean logic effectively deals with these binary values. Binary decision, the decision which results into either yes or true or no means false, is called a binary decision. Truth values, values true and false are called truth values. Boolean variables can have value either as 1 or as 0. So this is the concept of Boolean logic. Now, here you can see one image is included. There are some circles and some first two circles. First, here you can see cats and dogs. And operator is here. एंड ऑपरेटर इट रिट्राइव्स आइटम्स दैट कंटेन बोथ टर्म्स. सपोज द फर्स्ट सर्कल शोज द कैट्स एंड सेकेंड सर्कल शोज द डॉग्स. यू कैन यूज इन प्लेस ऑफ कैट्स एक्स और एनी अदर वेरिएबल लाइक वाई जेड W and in place of cats and dogs you can use any other variable. So here suppose the first circle shows the cats and second circle shows the dogs. So it is here it is written and operator. And operator means it will contain both the terms. It retrieves items that contain both terms. You can see first two circles it's showing the concept of and operator. And the second two circles cats or dogs or dogs it retrieves items that contain either term means either cats either dogs like that. Then the cats not dogs not operator is here. You can see last two circles it retrieves items that contain only one term. So this three operators and or not we will discuss it in detail in the next slides. So let's see, here you can see some points are given. First is compound statement or logical functions. Compound statements, first is he prefers tea not coffee, not operator is here. Second is he plays guitar and she plays sitar. He plays guitar and she plays sitar. And means as well as, means both the conditions are included here. In case of not only one, he prefers tea, not coffee. And the third sentence is I watch TV on Sundays or I go for swimming, or either or, I watch TV or I go for swimming. So just like the here we can use variable like x, y, z, x not y or z, x, y not x or z, just like this. Now the next is truth tables. It is important here, truth tables. You can see two tables are given here. In the first table, two variables x and y, and r is showing the result or output. And in the second table, you can see x, y, z. Three variables are there, x, y, z. And R is showing the just result or output. So, in the first table, you can see two variables, x, y. Two variables means how many values? It means 2 to power 2. If two variables there, then we can calculate the value. You can show the values 2 to power 2 equals to 4 values. And if three variables are there, it means you can use x, y, z. X, y, z means 2 to power 3. 8 values are there. You just, you can see the second table is showing three variables x, y and z. That is 2 to power 3 equals to 8 values. I think z is missing there with that arrow detail. You can write there three variables x, comma y, comma z. That is 2 to power 3 equals to 8 values. So, this truth table means what? Just see the definition now. Left side, you can see definition is written here. Truth table, it is a table. You can see table is there. It is a table which represents all the possible values. Values means 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, whatever is written here. 1, 1, 0, 0. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. These all are values. So, it is a table which represents all the possible values of logical variables. Logical variables, variable means x, y, z. These all are variables. Okay. Along with all the possible results. Along with all the possible results means this R. This last column R. R is showing the result. Okay. So, it is a table which represents all the possible values of logical variables along with all the possible results of the given combination of values. Given combination of values. Given combination means x and y combination, x, y and z combination. Suppose it is 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 0. This is the combination. So these two tables are just examples. We will solve the questions related to this. So here last point is 2 to power n values in a table where n denotes the number of variables. So this is the concept of truth table. Now here two concepts are given, tautology and falsity. Tautology. So let's see what is this tautology. In the first table you can see R. In the column R it is written 1 1 1 1, only 1 is written there. So if, so you can see the definition now, tautology. If the result of any logical statement, if the result of any logical statement or expression is always true, is always true or 1 for all input combinations, input combinations means x and y values, it is called tautology. Simply we can say if result is 1 1 1 1, it means true. At that time we can see this is tautology. And falsity, you can see the another table at the bottom in the column R, it is written 0 0 0 0 0, only 0, result is 0 only. So if the result of any logical statement or expression is always false or 0 for all input combinations, it is called falsity. Okay, this is the concept here. Now one more thing I have included here, binary number system. It is you can see left side two columns are given, decimal and binary. Decimal, we know decimal number system 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. It is given here. So, if we are writing 0 in decimal, then in binary we can write 0, 0, 0, 0. And if we are writing 1 in decimal, then in binary it is 0, 0, 0, 1. Then if we are writing 2, in decimal, then in binary it will be 0 0 1 0, and like this, all this. So this is the 0 to 15. You can you know about decimal numbers, then how will you remember the binary numbers for this 0 1 2 3 up to 15? So here is a trick. You can see right side one table is given, here some variables w, x, y, z, four columns, and in the first column W, there you can see 8 times 0 is written. 8 times 0 is written. Then after that 8 times 1 is written. 8 times 1 is written. And in the second column X, 4 times 0, then 4 times 1, then 4 times 0, then 4 times 1. Then in the column Y, it is 2 times 0, 2 times 1, then again 2 times 0, 2 times 1, 2 times 0, 2 times 1, 2 times 0, 2 times 1. In the last column Z, it is written 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1, like this. Okay, so these are four columns, and if combinedly we can we see the first row 0 0 0 0 0, we will get the binary for this zero number. And in the second row you can see 0 0 0 1, this is the second binary number for the decimal 1. And the third one row 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0. So you can see that how can you remember this binary numbers using this trick. Just you can follow this. Four columns are here, and in the first column 8 times 0, 8 times 1. Second column 4 times 0, 4 times 1. Third column 2 times 0, 2 times 1. Fourth column 0 1 0 1 0, and you will get the binary number for the equivalent decimal number. So this is the concept here. Now
here we are going to start our topic logical operators. So there are three kind of logical operators: and or not. First we will see not operator. It can be denoted like x bar or complement, x complement we can say. So this not operator operates on single variable, means we can say x, only x will be there, or only y will be there, or only z, or any other single variable. And operation performed by not operator is called complementation, and the symbol we use for it is bar. So thus x bar or x complement means complement of x, and suppose yz bar is written there, it means complement of yz. The variables used in Boolean equations have a unique characteristics that they may assume only one of two possible values, 0 and 1, where 0 denotes false and 1 denotes true value. You can see 0 bar equals to 1, 1 bar equals to 0. And this is the truth table, x and x bar is written there. In the first column you can see 0 1. Why only two variables are here? Because 2 to power 1, why? Because one variable is here, only x is used. It means 2 to power 1 equals to 2. That's why only 0 and 1. If x and y both variables are used at that time, you can use 2 to power 2. 2 to power 2 means 2 equals to 4. So this is the concept here. X means 0, 1, x bar. X bar is just opposite to x. X bar is just opposite to x. If value of x is 0, then at the time value of x bar is 1. And if value of x is 1, at the time value of x bar is 0. You can see one Venn diagram for x bar. So this is not operator. Not operator we can see just opposite of that particular first variable. Now here the second one operator is OR operator. OR operator, it denotes operation called logical addition, and the symbol we use for it is plus, logical OR symbol. So we can say this is logical addition, and plus symbol is used for this. So x plus y can be read as x or y. For OR operation, the possible input and output combinations are 0 plus 0 equals to 0. These are actually rules. We will see these rules. First, 0 plus 0 equals to 0. 0 plus 1 equals to 1. 1 plus 0 equals to 1. And 1 plus 1 equals to 1. We should remember this so that we can solve the questions. So 0 plus 0 equals to 0. 0 plus 1 equals to 1. 1 plus 0 equals to 1. And 1 plus 1 equals to 1. This is plus operator. Plus means logical addition, or operator, or it is called OR operator. You can see the truth table here. It's showing 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. And you can see one Venn diagram for this x plus y. Now, AND operator. This is the third one operator, AND operator. It denotes operation called logical multiplication. This AND is logical multiplication, and the symbol we use for it is dot, logical AND symbol, logical AND symbol. So x dot y can be read as x and y. So for AND operation, the possible input and output combinations are 0.00, 0.10, 1.00, and 1.11. So you can see the difference here. Then truth table is also given here for AND. AND means dot. Dot means multiplication operator. So this is AND operator 0.00, 0.10, 1.00 and 1.11. And you can see Venn diagram for this. Now, there is one example, or we can say question. We can solve this. So let's see. Question is, using Boolean logic, verify using truth table that x plus xy equals to x for each x comma y in 0, 1. So the solution is given here. As the expression x plus xy is equal to x is a two variable expression, so we require possible combination of values of x comma y. Truth table will be as follows. So there is the expression given x plus xy. So first this table x, and first column will be x there, second column will be y, and after that we will solve this x dot y, because in our question there is expression x plus xy. So first we will get x dot y, and after that the fourth column you can see here x plus x dot y. So first x and y, here two variables are given. It means 2 to power 2 means equals to 4. Four values means 2 times 0, 2 times 1 in the first column x, you can see 2 times 0, 2 times 1 means total 4 values. And the second column y, you can see 0 1 0 1. Okay, so x and y, then x dot y means 0.00, 0.10, 0, 1.0, 0, and 1.11. We have seen this rule in the previous slide. This is the concept of dot. Dot means AND operator. And after this, the last column you can see x plus xy. X plus xy means this x, first column, and the third column, 0 plus 0. 0 plus 0 means 0. 0 plus 0 means 0. 1 plus 0 means 1. And 1 plus 1 means 1. So you can see this. Here nothing, just AND and OR operator. AND and OR operator are used, and we know the rules in the previous slides. You can see again that rules. So this is the concept. And after that you can see last line is written here. Comparing the columns x plus xy and x, we find contents of both the columns are identical, hence verified. It means x plus y, the last column, and the x, the first column, both have same contents. It means we have proved this expression x plus xy equals to x. Okay, now one more question is given here. Using Boolean logic, verify using truth table that x plus y whole complement means whole bar equals to x bar dot y bar. This is the question. Okay, so let's see the solution. As it is two variable expression, truth table will be as follows. This is two variable means 2 to power 2. 2 to power 2 means 4. 4 values. So you can see x, first column x, 0, 0, 1, 1. Second column y, 0, 1, 0, 1. After that, there is x plus y. X plus y means 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 1, 1. This is x plus y. And x plus y, the fourth column you can see x plus y whole bar, whole complement. It means it is just opposite to x plus y, the third one column. So you can see third one column, if it is written 0, then in the fourth one column it is written 1. If in the third one column 1, 1, 1, and you can see the fourth one column 0, 0, 0. It means x plus y whole bar is just opposite to x plus y. Then x bar, it is just opposite to the first column x. You can see in the first column 0, 0, 1, 1. And in this column x bar, 1, 1, 0, 0. This is just opposite. Then y bar is just opposite to y. So it is written 1, 0, 1, 0. Now x bar dot y bar. X bar dot y bar, this is the last column here. X bar means 1100 and y bar means 1011. So dot means and operator. And operator means 1.11, 1.00, 0.10 and 0.00.
So you can see the result. Comparing the columns x plus y whole bar and x bar dot y bar, both the columns are identical, hence proved. So these are the questions. And the last question, this is your homework. Please note down these three questions A, B, C and solve these questions. Okay, thank you.